Good evening, everyone. It is once again Ted the Speed Learner, and I am here once again to declare the winner of the VRW. And the winner this week just happens to be Crazy Josh Cravey. Congratulations, Crazy Josh Cravey. You are once again the winner of the VRW. As you probably well know by now, I am running a live stream at the same time as I'm recording this for you. And I'm kind of looking back and forth, so you probably know what's going on here. Anyway, I'm going to start off with the South Whidbey Academy Senior Graduation Video 2018. Now, I want to say that I am very well aware that probably none of these people want to answer these questions. That's perfectly all right with me. I could tell them a couple of things, and I hope they do watch this. There's a couple of things I could tell them that might possibly change their minds. May not. Who knows? But And I've often found that sometimes somebody say, well, I'm not going to do this right now. And then later on in life, they're like, well, you know, maybe I'll change my mind and finally answer him. You know, these videos are going to be around for as long as I'm going to be around, at least. So it's not like I'm going to go away. So, you know, the first thing I'd like to do, first and foremost, is congratulate every student that was in the video. I think they accomplished quite a bit, and I congratulate them. So, good work to all of you. All right? Now, I realize the true significance of social media in the 21st century. I know this only too well. And I honestly feel, especially as competitive as social media is today, that it is important to be very forthcoming, okay? Let me tell you something out there. The competition in the global economy today is very fierce. And having a good reputation and getting the people to know who you are and to like what you do is very important. I can't tell you how critical it is. I'm going to give you an example of this. I wasn't the very first person in my town to get a YouTube partnership. I was not, actually. There was one other person that got a YouTube partnership back in 2011 before me. Okay? And this person acquired a lot of views, watch time, fame, and of course money as far as that's concerned. Now, at the time, the YouTube Partner Program was not what it is today. It was kind of in its infancy, and there were some people that were getting the idea that when you got your partnership letter, you were a millionaire. And that's not quite the case. I can tell you that right now. But trying to convince them of that was not easy. I can tell you that right now. It wasn't easy at all. And so what I tried to do when I got my partnership letter was I was trying to show people that just because you got a partnership letter did not mean you were going to be an instant millionaire. And I think pretty much I've succeeded. I mean, does it look like I'm a millionaire? Do I act like a millionaire? Of course not. not hardly. So that did become a problem, not only for myself, but for the other person that got their partnership around the same time as I did. Okay, actually, they got theirs before I did. And that became kind of a difficulty. Now, I grant you, after a while, everybody finally caught on. They knew that some people did better on the partnership program than others. And so they were a little less likely to go, well, gee, he's got his partnership letter, so he must be a millionaire. Like, not all of us. Okay. So, but if I hadn't been more forthcoming about my partnership at that time, people might still to this day might think that everybody that gets a partnership letter from YouTube is a millionaire. Doesn't work that way. Really doesn't work that way. So, now that you guys all know that. But there is another story that might compel you even further, and I'll tell you this next one. I actually developed a text-to-speech software. I actually have the code for that. I was using Microsoft Word. They have a Visual Basic thing in Microsoft Word where you can actually code a Visual Basic. And I was able to code it, hook it up to an Access database, and I had a lot of sound clips, and they were part of a special folder that the database was able to access, so on and so forth. Okay. But the thing was that nobody knew me at the time. And because they didn't know me, they didn't trust my programming. Like, well, I don't want you ruining my computer. And back then, that was a big deal. Of course, nowadays, it's not that big of a deal. But back then, it was a very big deal. And so I ran into the difficulty of marketing my software because nobody knew who I was or what I was capable of. And that's kind of one of the things that I was trying to solve that by being on YouTube. That was one of the things I was trying to solve. Of course, there were some other things I wanted to solve as well. But that was one of the motivations I had for getting on YouTube, was to solve this little problem of, golly gee and willikers, these people don't know me and they're not going to buy my products because they don't know who I am and they don't know what I'm capable of. And by doing what I did, I was able to prove successfully I could do this kind of stuff, and the rest is history. Besides, I got quite a fan following, so I was thrilled. Okay? So, a good reputation these days is absolutely essential in the United States job market. I don't know how it is in Canada, but I know down here it is really essential. And one of the fastest ways for people to get to know your good reputation is to get on YouTube and just let them know. It's just something for you guys to think about. You don't have to do anything, but I'm just saying this is something for you to think about. Just a little thought there. So, and I can help with that. I really can. So, anyway, I'm going to go ahead and ask these questions. I'm pretty sure nobody will ever answer them, but, oh, never hurts to ask. Never hurts to knock on that door. Maybe nobody will ever answer, but you knock on the door anyway. Who knows? Anyway, I saw a young lady in the video. It was at the beginning of the video, and she was standing on the table, and I was like, why are you standing on a table? Just kind of want to know. All right, and I also saw another young lady. She was sitting on a chair with a laptop on her lap and a bottle of soda sitting next to her. Was she watching a video on the laptop, or was she just listening to music? I couldn't tell. I don't know what was on her screen. Shoot, she might have been even reading. I don't know. All right. On the video, we had Brittany Rankin. My question to her would be, do you have any advice for others who are also struggling with math? I'd like to know. Aiden Porter, if you're out there, what was your greatest challenge in your graphic design class? I'd like to know. And if I mispronounce any of your names, I apologize in advance. I think your name is Leon DeShong. What was your favorite period in history? And, you know, history has various periods, like the Roman era, the medieval times, the 20th century. What was your favorite period of history? Okay, and what did you learn in fashion class? I'd kind of like to know. And how do you plan to market your line of clothing? I'd like to know. Serenity Fernandez. Here's what I'd like to know. What investments would you recommend to your friends? Mia Jackson, I'd like to know. What kind of artwork do you create? Alyssa Torrey, have you ever written a book? If so, have you ever tried to publish it? You know, they have that Amazon Kindle publishing, and it's worth a try. Who knows? Somebody might buy some of your books. Maybe you've written more than one. I'd like to see them. Okay? I actually feel kind of bad that normal high schools these days require so many credits to graduate. It wasn't like that when I was back in high school. How many credits do you think high schools should require students to have to graduate? Okay. All right. Giovanni Thomas, what did you learn about ancient Egypt? I'd be kind of fascinated to know myself. Sebastian Schuhl, I believe that's your last name. What classes were you wanting to take? Makita Brown, you had mentioned that you were going into a web development career. Have you ever thought about helping Leon Deshong develop a web page for his clothing company? And if so, have you ever contacted him? Have you talked to him about it? Mikael Whitlock, I believe that's how you pronounce your name. If not, I apologize. You said you were going to learn robotics in college. What kind of robots do you plan to design and build? I'd really like to know. All right. Now, Crazy Josh Cravey, you actually uploaded a video entitled Geology Rocks. And now I'm going to ask questions to you. What species of trees are in the background? What caused the seismic activity? How deep was the sinkhole? Why was it the person talking about igneous rocks wearing a red jacket? And if I mispronounce that, I apologize in advance. Do any of these rocks assist in growing crops? I'd like to know. All right, and then you finally uploaded a video entitled Death at a Wedding, Divorce at a Funeral. Yes, I did turn on the closed captioning. It's a great video. Good job in singing it. Anyway, we're just going to go based on the song lyrics. That's what I'm just asking. It's not, quote, asking to you, but I'm just saying the person that was being described in this particular video, or in this particular song, that is. How long had you known Isabella? What did the engagement ring look like? How many people attended the wedding? You say you lost your lunch. What did you eat for lunch? How many children did Uncle Ronnie have? What did Isabella have to say about the funeral? I would love to know. Feel free to leave the answers to any and all these questions down here in the comments below, and I want to congratulate you once again for winning the Video Response Wars. Good work to you. And if anybody wants to answer, I'm willing to listen, and if they don't, well, we'll just have to take it from there. All right. I want to thank you for participating in the Video Response Wars contest, and congratulations once again, and you keep up the good work. And Spin Wheel Videos, if you want to participate in the Video Response Wars contest, follow the example set by Crazy Josh Cravey, and make sure that you tell us that that's what you want to do, and I'll be happy to feature you here. All right. I will tell you more in a future video. I hope you guys have a great week. And by all means, stay tuned.